Playerunknown's Battleground, you know, that game Twitch is obsessed with and that apparently everyone wants to try? Well, you know how that early access game is so unoptimized even some gaming computers have trouble with it? If you want to have a shot at trying this game in a low-end computer, you're going to need some tweaks to reduce the graphics. How much? Just a bit. Yeah, a bit. Welcome to the LowSpecGamer, the show where I find ways of playing modern games on low-end computers by forcing the graphics lower and lower. And in this episode, somehow, we're making PlayerUnknown's Battleground run. Hey, do you remember Action Recorder, the game recorder that I featured as a sponsor in my Crysis 3 video after testing and realizing how efficient it was on low-end computers? Their software is currently on a summer sale, 33% off. So if you're interested, check the link in the description, because the sale only lasts this weekend. Hurry up! PlayerUnknown's Battleground is a game that is still officially unreleased, but currently available in Early Access. Now, before we begin, a note that apparently a ton of people online need to hear. This is an early access game, meaning that it is incomplete and unoptimized. Meaning that it will have problems even on high-end computers and only the developer can fully fix it, and some of the tweaks in this video might change in the future. Alright? Good. Which is also why I will be using the GTX 460, which was a mid-range card on 2010 and absolutely sucks for this game, even with the lowest settings possible. What a surprise. In order to reduce the graphics further, the first step is using this tool, the Advanced Launcher. This tool, which you can download in the description, can be used to simplify part of the process. Big thanks to this tool's developer for contacting me and letting me know it was in development. In the tool settings, you need to set the location of your configuration file by making sure it is pointed to the right username here. You can confirm your username in the user folder of your hard drive, and keep this configuration file location in mind, because we'll be heading there in a minute. In the game's settings section, you can load your existing settings, make sure they're all to the minimum, and these two variables control the game's internal resolution. As you probably already know, internal resolution controls the overall detail of the image without affecting the UI, so you can have a more pixelated game without changing external resolution. Pretty useful for weaker GPUs. Normally, the game only allows you to drop it to 70%, but the launcher will allow you to go as low as 20%. This might, however, affect your capacity to distinguish things in the distance, as you will notice in a moment. In the launch options section, you can add a group of launch options that might help a bit on achieving a more stable FPS. Be sure to set the memory option to your amount of RAM in megabytes and refresh to your monitor's refresh rate in the refresh option. And you're going to need to apply, and every time you want to play, you need to hit the launch button on the launcher for the commands to work. One minor note, the DirectX 10 command does not seem to work for the moment, so you can just ignore it. Now there's an additional thing you can manually do by going into the configuration folder, once again located at your user folder, app data, local, DSL game, save, config, Windows no editor, and we're going to change a file called engine.ini. If you have been following the channel for the last month or so, you might have noticed that I have been experimenting with a bunch of Unreal Engine 4 commands that you can add on this file under a render settings section. You can find these variables in the link in the description. For this game, two main things will change. The first is that while it does not seem to be possible to completely remove shadows, you can reduce the resolution to this pixelated mess. The second is that the indoor areas will become much darker, which can make the game harder indoors but provide a strong FPS boost. Let me show you how this pixelated mess looks after you try all those things.
Well, there's another, there's like three more players in this area, so this is going to be... I cannot see. This is so confused. I cannot... Okay. Hunt is on for gear and equipment, I guess. Could this weapon reload any slower? Well, it's something. I mean, I'm not entirely even sure if I will be able to see other players. There's more than just a group of pixels. Oh, wait, I listened to... I heard someone. Oh, boy. Well, that was quick. Well, at least the visibility is better. And I got a gun with no ammo. I am... absolutely dominating at this game. So skilled. Whoa! Wow, that guy aims is terrible. So keep in mind, however, that your visibility with this sort of low resolution is reduced, especially at large distances. But it's a matter of whether you need more performance or visibility. It's always a balance with this kind of thing, especially in online games. Game is doing pretty fine considering the speed that I'm moving at. You can clearly see how the game struggles to lower the reality if you're moving fast, but so far I will say it's somewhat manageable. Ah! Holy shit. I swear, why do I always sign up places that have like nothing interesting happening? Oh look, a single magazine and no weapons. Yeah! Okay, we're doing fine. I think I might be finally getting the hang of this.
That is all for this video. Thank you to all the kind souls in Patreon that continue to fund this channel. I will see you all on the next one.